And welcome back to the extra long run where we are playing Xenoblade Chronicles 3. Don't mind if I sound a little annoyed, I just realized that I was not actually streaming the last part, so...
Yeah. I should write this all down.
That would explain why no one was around while I was streaming, but in the long run. Anyway, here are some consoles.
Alright, eyes up front.
The traitors have arrived. Or perhaps I should call you beasts, driven by my hounds.
So you're the consul for Colony 11?
Ouroboros scum! Have a care for how you address me. With a single order, I could have you creatures crushed this instant.
Mm-hmm. I somehow doubt that.
It appears you understand. Now stay right there. I will dispose of you later.
What?
First, I'll deal with you, former Commander Ashera. Step forward.
Hey! Rude!
With all due respect, Madam Consul, you called us traitors just now. If I, never mind them, am to be accused of the crime of treason, I'm afraid the great consul will have to enlighten us as to the reason. Beasts that we are.
You are as impudent as ever. But I will explain to you this one time. You engage in battle without orders. Use deviant tactics in battle. You openly violate military regulations. And your worst crime of all? Multiple, unforgivable flights towards a consul.
Yeah, I'm
Don't
sure that's the one.
Don't bother trying to deny it. All of the soldiers here have witnessed this.
And as a result, we have brought many victories for Keves. Aren't glory and military success what the consul desires?
And when did I hand out such orders? Never forget that all of you are pawns.
I mean, literally, you're playing chess with our lives.
It is placed on the board. A pawn that acts on its own has no more worth than the mud under my boot.
Chirp! Talking to our own soldiers like that.
However, well, throwing away a silver colony, no matter how rotten, is hardly the action of a wise woman. At present, bringing Colony 11 under my direct control is the more pressing matter.
So, you have no further use for me.
I should think a suicidal maniac like you would cherish being destroyed by her countrymen.
You. Shut your rotten mouth.
I see. And it seems you have been laboring under several misconceptions, Madam Consul.
How foolish. You use this chance to spout more drivel.
Until now, Colony 11 would rush off to battle wherever you waved your hand. But you see, we did it because we wished to. If there was a battle we felt was worthy of us, we soldiers would give our lives fighting it. That's all we ever wanted. My soldiers. And myself.
What are you driving at?
Looking at it another way, nothing else matters to us but that. Not even fighting against people who were our allies until only yesterday. And not even obeying someone who isn't worthy of being our master. Is it dawning on you yet?
What? What are you blathering about?
The pawns you thought were faithful to you were truly worth less to you than the mud under your boot. Since the very beginning.
Cease your confounded blathering! This instant! How dare you!
Ugh, this is getting on my nerves. If it's all the same to you, I'd really like to drop it now. So, come and kill me, if you can.
No.
you seek. I'll be delighted to grant you it, you worthless scum!
Wow, she turned into a monster. Now I've seen everything.
Getting scared, are you?
Do I look scared?
No, you really don't. Just forget it.
Ashera, don't underestimate her. She's not like anything else you've fought.
Yeah, I'm getting that impression. Well then, Ouroboros. Time for the fight we've all been waiting for.
Like this.
Better do something about that.
I'll bring you all before.
I know. But they can't pay for this.
creatures. You're all pawns. Nothing but pawns.
She's still alive.
What's wrong? Go on. Kill me. Isn't that what you want? You animal.
Nope. What?
What?
Queen's wings, have you lost the snuffing plot? She's Mobius, she's the enemy.
Yeah, but ending it like this... How should I put it? Oh, I know. It's a waste.
Are you insane? In fact, never mind. Forget I asked.
There you have it, Madam Consul. You can make a strategic retreat. Do whatever, I don't mind. If you're planning revenge, by all means, pay Colony 11 another visit.
You. You bitch!
Or, if you actually definitely do want to die, I have no qualms in speeding you along.
Oh, you will pay for making me look a fool. You'll pay dearly.
The consul, Mobius, she's more dangerous than you know.
Oh, I know that. That's why I'm expecting big things from her.
Wow. I don't know what to say. This woman is something else.
Right. A victory needs fireworks. Make it something big. You came all this way.
Is she saying what I think she's saying?
She does have a point, I suppose.
You guys are a silver colony. You sure about this?
Didn't you hear my speech? I said nothing else matters. Not to us. So?
Got you.
Here we go!
There. You're all free now. No need to fight. No need to take life from others.
I wonder if you can really call that freedom.
Care to explain?
My soldiers and I, we've been ever fighting for the sake of earning life in the first place.
Back up. Surely you had to be, right? I mean, that's the usual setup.
True. Normally you'd fight to keep the clock fed. Only natural. Otherwise you're dead. But for us, we live so we can fight. It's how we've lived our lives.
Living to fight sounds kind of awful.
You must understand, now that you've crossed blades with my troops, they didn't follow the consul's orders because they were frightened for their lives. We were using the situation we're in to our advantage.
Huh? What's the point of that?
I should think it's obvious. We hope that someday we can have a proper fight to the death. With mighty warriors like you. I've taken part in all these battles to make that dream real. That's all.
I see.
No, not I see, Senna. Just think about it for a sec. These guys have been killing each other, having their own little murder party. It's crazy.
Yep, if you're going to be blunt about it, then that's exactly what it was.
That doesn't make it any better. All this living to fight crap. How many lives will you need to take before you're satisfied? Or maybe you want to die, is that it?
Yes, I want to die. Good try.
I mean, okay, sure.
Wait, you ain't serious.
Is it that surprising? A soldier like you should...
Grow the snuff up. Grow up, I said. So you want to fight? You want to die? What the snuff is your problem?
You come out with all this highfalutin crap, but really, that consul was right about you. You're nothing but a bloodthirsty beast, aren't you?
Hang on, Uni.
You listen. You ain't gonna involve us in your stupid suicidal quest. Just leave us alone, all right?
Uni, that was out of all...
Point Dexter. Wow, I am pretty exhausted after all this. I think I'll take a load off somewhere. Oh, you can all make yourselves at home. Consider it a thank you for joining the fight.
Ashera, shouldn't we?
Well then, I'll be off. What you do is up to you.
Uni, that was not cool. I want you to apologize later.
Please tell me you're not taking her side.
Everyone should be free to choose how they want to live their life. Wasn't Ethel the same?
Oi, she's nothing like Ethel, got it?
Well, that's for sure. But you did kind of go overboard there.
Uni, I know how you feel, but could you try?
Fine, you win, whatever. I'll talk to her, will that do?
Sure.
Psych.
Well, I'm starting to think the class inheritor might not be a Lance. Well, let's wrap up this quest and see what happens.
Hey.
Hmm?
I want to talk about before. I'm sorry. I went too far. What are you laughing at? I'm being serious here.
Sorry. It's just, you surprised me. And I don't think you went too far. What you said was the unvarnished truth.
And that stuff about wanting to die?
Even without flame clocks, people die at some point. Be it sooner or later. So, before that happens, I want to leave my mark on this world. Some kind of proof that we were here. In the short time we've been given. For me, that is what I want to achieve by dying.
Sorry, I still don't get it. It seriously just sounds like you want to destroy yourself.
Dying to fight and fighting to die are different, though they might sound the same. If I can make my death mean something, then I can finally prove my life had value. Live fiercely, die spectacularly. That's how I want the battlefield of my life to be. Well, all that said, looking from the outside, all people see is the suicidal maniac. And Colony 11 is the last refuge for people like us. Isn't that funny?
I don't see the joke. You really are insane.
How many times have you said that today?
I suppose. But, you know.
At least now I get that you're not enough of an idiot to throw yourself off the top of here.
And your life really is yours to do with as you see fit. It's not my place to go off on you just because we don't see eye to eye. Besides, the way you fight, fearless and fierce and all that, honestly, it's kind of awesome.
Yeah? Think so, eh?
What? Revving up for another dig?
No. How do I put it? No one's ever talked that way to me before. I guess I'm happy, maybe?
You ain't embarrassed, are you? You!
Yeah? Couldn't you tell I was joking?
I really seriously hate you.
Aww, that hurts! And here I was taking a liking to you. I mean, from now on, we're all fellow rebels. So, you know. You and I should be friends, Uni.
Your quest, the Wrath of Ashera, complete. The party put an end to the fight with Colony 11, but having learned the reason why Ashera fights as she does, Uni anticipates further trouble ahead. We have a marked... Yes, exactly.
Oh,
I said, that's what I was gonna say. And I thought the class inheritor was going to be Lance, but no, it's actually gonna be Uni. Ashera's class Lone Exile, Role Defender, accumulates heavy aggro through attacks, can also counterattack when an ally in range has been attacked.
Are you tired? We can rest a while.
That'd be welcome.
So let's go ahead and change Uni's class back to...
I'll hit him, over. And then I'm gonna hit him again!
3, 8, 4. I was wondering if there might be like an X across her face or something, because she's kind of sort of dead now. But no.
I'm seriously knackered.
Actually, here. Let's go. Yeah, good thing I checked, because. Okay, so that's leading us out to the castle. And not this way into the castle, which would be a terrible idea. But that is a landmark, so it was a good thing we tagged that at the very least.
What to buy?
Buy one of everything. What's in here?
We need to time this right. On it!
I mean, it's not like it's that hard to get the timing down for that. And as usual, there is a container.
Wonder what's inside.
And there's a container over there too. Camera, please. Oh my goodness. Yeah, there's a tiny platform there. If the camera would cooperate a little bit better, maybe I could figure out how to get there. Oh, this is precarious, and I don't like it at all.
Cool. We can make use of this.
Don't look down. We're fine. Got it. Okay. And there is a container over here. Heh. Yeah, let's say you could have done that. So what you're saying is you guys are Klingons.
Could you help me out here?
On it.
But that's what this is. This is a colony of friggin' Klingons. You too. Nice weather we're having today.
Good to add more names.
Is it? These guys are a little intense.
Better make sure we're well rested.
Well, we have something to discuss.
I think we need to discuss this.
Ashera. What will Colony 11 do now? Why ask me? Try not to play dumb. Maybe he's asking because it's your colony. No. Surely it's your colony now, if anything. What? Just how do you figure that? I figured by how soundly Colony 11 was thrashed into submission by the treasures or books. They say to the victor goes the spoils. Therefore, Colony 11 now belongs to you lot. You're also on the winning side, if memory serves. Ah, if the commander herself says it's fine, who are we to argue? All this of allies is limited. We're grateful for any cooperation. Oh, I forgot to tell you something. We're fickle lot in Colony 11. Most of us do as we please. So you should be careful how you handle us. Just because I've taken a liking to you doesn't mean the others will. Why can't you just explain our good qualities to them? Get them to help us. What? I should just tell them directly? A bunch of people will cut me down if I show any weakness? Nah, I guess that won't work. But then what the spark are we supposed to do? Let me give you a piece of advice as former commander. In Colony 11, there's a group of elite soldiers called the Three Ravens. Three? You don't remember? They fought us on Ixia Bridge. Oh, those guys. Their names were... let me think. Spearhead Zoran, Felbloom Easel, and Tenacious Clad. Mainly the three units that make up Colony 11. You could call them the pillars of the colony. When those three have only basically got the whole colony. You make it sound simple. How are you meant to win them over, exactly? Good question. I simply crushed them until they did my bit. Queen's teeth. No wonder they want to kill you. But I know that you lot can play it a bit smarter than that. For example, you could glean some intel about them. The best way to know about your enemy is to become their friend. Whoa. They may be a group of thugs, but as soldiers go, they're the best of the best. Not as good as me, obviously. Can't see any downside to winning them over. They'll do wonders for your ally base. How about it? You're not wrong there. We'll think it over. Thinking, is it? Don't deliberate over it for too long. What's that supposed to mean? Leave that lot alone for too long and they'll end up in some battle or another. You better do something about them before they end up being a nuisance for someone else. Is trouble seriously all your colony's good for? Might be. Well, I wish you luck. Three ravens at war. Oh, let's get our bellies filled, shall we? Mild delicious. Games, too. This is far from being a mild game.
Has everybody had their fill?
Mild sizzle fizzle stew.
So that's a new recipe then.
And save our farming so far. It is good to keep a record.
Let's keep things on a tight loop.
Good to add more names. I see some relations have changed.
Weasels use this patch, they don't play games. Does anyone play games? Okay, so now we have some information on all three units. So now let's go back to the canteen and have another chat.
Better make sure we're well rested. Let's lay out the facts.
That Zorn guy. Pretty sure he was first on scene when we tangled with Colony 11. Zorn's unit makes up the main fold of Colony 11. The Vanguard compromise comprised of shock troopers. In battle, they specialize in breaking through the enemy vanguard and wreaking havoc among the enemy forces. Yeesh, that sounds about right. Sounds like a bunch of people just like Ashera. Leaving them alone is probably the worst thing we could do. We should probably talk to them as soon as we can. You said they gather at the west gate, right? That sounds right. Better head out.
I think we need to discuss this.
They say the Cladion is the cornerstone of Colony 11's defense. They draw the enemy in so Zorn's unit can focus on attack and Ezel's unit can deliver support. I'm surprised their roles are so evenly divided. They're specialists in combat. Even if they're a rotten bunch, they're silver rank elites. We know almost nothing about the Captain Clad. He's always wearing a helmet. I wonder if anyone's ever seen his face. All we do know is that he constantly drills his troops in training pits. Training pits? Like the plaza where we fought all. Apparently, that's what they call one of those in Colony 11. I get it. Well, why don't we pay them a visit? You might get lucky and bump into him. Indomitable. And
I think we need to discuss this.
What sort of group is Ezel's unit? They're more of a rearguard unit. They fire from a distance and support the front line. Seems that Colony 11's canteen is also under their control. Canteen? How come? Who knows? They just hear that Ezel's unit is usually there. So if we win him over, we could we get our pick of all the best food. Oh, that'd be awesome. I think I can get behind that. Sometimes I'm jealous of the way you two think. No, seriously. Okay, so that is all of the discussion. Let's see also what level this Three Ravens at War is of. 53. So it's maybe one of those quests that we're meant to kind of do over a long period of time. Okay, so I guess we're dealing with Clyde first. I mean, was there ever any doubt of that, Tyone? You mothers. What do you think she's doing? Well, change of plans. I wasn't going to be doing this one first, but this is what we're doing first. Holy crap, they're level 49. I don't think this is going to go well. And Noah's already. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been a terrible idea. Okay, let's carefully not go into the center this time. Okay, go away too. Isn't Colony Lambda dead? So isn't that like a ways away? Let's see. Like Colony Lambda is Pentalus region. Oh boy, here we go. Also, I really don't need to see Noah's butt. Okay, so it is around here. So there's a quest marker over here. Yeah, did I miss? Hang on, where is? Where am I supposed to be going? Let's start over here. That's closer, but not quite. Cross there. Okay, here we are. Thank you. Oh, I'm seeing where that line is leading us. That was a little unnerving when the line leads us directly down. But in this case, there's actually a climbable surface. You say that as though we haven't operated one of these previously. I mean, I guess it has been 2 weeks since the last episode.
Let's use this.
I don't get people calling very often. Excuse me. The smell of what? Stop smelling me, that's creepy. Yes. She knows where we are. We have no idea exactly where she is. But probably around here somewhere. I don't doubt it, Yumi. I don't doubt it. But at least it's giving us hiding spots. Yep, sure is. Interesting that it's bringing us over to this one first. I don't know if that's for a reason or not. That I did see over there. See, someone wanted to get a good view as they died.
We can't just leave this be.
Also an ego channel down there and a container too. You know what?
Make use of this.
quiet.
You can never go wrong with some ether.
Let's see if we can get back up to where we were using this ladder. Yeah, this is where we were indeed.
Whoa, got a rare doodah right here.
Okay. Now we actually can deal with them. But we're in the middle of another quest, and I kind of don't want to get distracted. Is that at least on the map? Yes, it is. Well, hello. Basically, our entire thing is we want to stop your operation. Forces invading Lambda. So, wait, which Kavesi force? I mean, I guess we kind of are done talking. It'd be nice if this sort of game actually allowed for like three-way battles. But you rarely see standard RPGs where there are three sides to one single battle. Y'all just follow my goofuses. So, who are we going to end up dealing with here? Are we going to end up dealing with them, or are we going to end up dealing with the other Kavesi force? Yeah, that sounds like Colony 11 to me. Leave it to Uni. They've lost their big boy dance. What I'm saying is, fight the Kevesi force. There we go. More or less, yeah. Indeed.
Surprise attack. Cute. Come on in.
I don't want to focus our attacks here, because this is a lot of these. I don't think I can make a 11 this believe, but let's try. That's a lot of aggro on Noah. I don't like it.
Why?
Of course there is another wave. I'm gonna wreck it! Dang it. A block is changing me. Also, I still have a lot of aggro on me and I'm gonna die. Okay, I think we got rid of the aggro. Get the rest of yours. Sniper next. Sniper. That's all the little guys done. Let's get the Sagittarius. He goes down. We are out of healers, actually. Let's go ahead and chain attack. Do what we can here, because I would like to not lose this battle. Ha, 2 points! That's because I don't think it's going to matter all that much. We got one left, but we got no healers, so we need to do this thing. Okay, we did it. Whew, felt the pressure on that one. Playing with their wings.
Oh,
No? You think so? Alright, well, if that's what you think. I'm pretty sure we're dealing with an entire colony of idiots, I'm not gonna lie. There. Okay. Fair enough. Oh, I guess there are some people like that, huh? Yeah, if you want to fight, y'all can help us with our fight against the Annihilator. A warrior's pride, complete. The party and Zoran's squad defended Lambda from another Kevesi army. Zoran and company welcomed the opportunity to see some action with open arms.
I see some relations have changed.
Now, there's a quest that the game has been dangling in my face. For many a level. Let's see. Supply drop landed all the way over there. Yeah. I'll check out that supply drop before I do that quest. Oh, I also see a location of a husk over there. I can see the smoke coming out there.
No one's gonna mind if we just yoink the stuff.
Yeah, I'm sure they won't. Containers are locked? Excuse me, sir. Can you please unlock this?
But you're in our way.
Say apologies with me on the job.
Or yes, you have to kick your butts in order to unlock this. So I guess let's do that. I like how they just kind of stood there and did absolutely nothing until you actually engaged them. The rescue down.
Wow,
It is still locked. I didn't think
I'll
so.
Need a hand here.
Of course.
It's fine, they're all fine. We don't shoot to kill, so... Anyway, like I was saying... The game has been dangling a quest in my face for like the last 15 levels. Let's finally get it on. And these ranged classes don't have a whole lot of range to them, again, finding out here. Gave us information about Sequoia. I guess one way to get information about someone is to, well, beat their ass. Aha! You're done being a thaumaturge. You can be more medic.
Leave the healing to me.
You're at your best equipment. You're also done.
I'll keep you safe and snug.
And then we have. Alright, we should probably now get back to a camp and have a little discussion.
We could do with some food. Could you all come around for a second?
Dude, that Sequoia's shooting range was ludicrous, am I right? Anyway, we went, shots were falling on us like hail. From what I heard, she used to be a close-range attacker before. Maybe that explains why she was so good at keeping the right distance. Ugh, who makes a switch like that? Sounds like way too much effort. Maybe that's exactly the kind of reaction she's expecting out of you guys. Ugh. She's also an accomplished intelligence operative supporter. She can usually get into her enemy's heads before battles. Wow, she must have loved Lance then. So nice and roomy, and the acoustics. Oi, who you calling roomy, Fed? And anyway, we beat him, didn't we? Hey, come on, no need to get upset. Colony Iota's already looking way less intimidating. Let's just keep it up. Okay, I wasn't fishing for a pep talk. And I wouldn't have been upset if Uni just kept her mouth shut.
Okay,
I see
just
some relations have changed.
So did that. Not sure really what that did. Maybe if you look at the map now, there'll be another quest marker. There's a bunch of mess here. What's going on? There's a lot of ether channels. Cool. The point of interest. Oh. There's also the matter of this here, which we can actually traverse. Oh, did I not talk to you? Not on cooking.
This is some story.
I mean, it's a lovely view from, like, a lot of places. You guys okay? Your pathfinding's slightly broken again. Also, your little map there seems to be clipping into the ground. Cross this again. Ugh. Straight ahead. It's fine. Cool. Where's the ladder upward? Nervous at all, what are you talking about?
If we slid along that,
we would die.
Take the fast way.
Oh dear. This has been a bad decision. Y'all are just here to destroy our faces.
I hope we can make use of this.
But I'm just going to take this this container and hopefully leave without fighting. Thank you, goodbye now. At least now we know. Alright. So that's where one of the supers are in this game. There's also this point of interest here. What's that about? Go ahead and put a marker.
How about we go here?
Alright, there. Markers over here.
Say, over there. If we slid along that.
Go ahead and unmark that.
Time to take the fast way.
Guess that's one way to think. Yeah, that's exactly what I'm worried about, Neo Tyon and Ashera. To actually deploy this before I use it.
Like so. And then here and.
Why was that not deployed? That's my question. There's a husk over there, and there's a lot of them over there, and there's a uni here.
We're sliding down.
Yes, thank you for pointing out the obvious. But this shouldn't take too long. Shinra Marco, if that is your real name. Although I do feel like these probably scale a little bit. But this guy should go down a lot faster than this. Energy Pichu. It occurs to me that this super, the talent art that I have, takes a long time to charge, and I'm not really sure how this.
Teamwork couldn't handle.
Whatever happened to not being careless?
You can never go wrong with some ether.
You get a named grave? I get an ether channel. Now let's send off all these guys.
Well, hey, look at that.
We can't just leave this be.
I do appreciate how the game actually remembers that they traded flutes. One thing that I think would be even more wild is if they had also traded melodies.
So much to see, huh?
I hope we can make use of this.
And I think this is just the container. Not much of a cavern, honestly. But this looks crafted. Hey, buddy. You're not gonna bother me, are you? No? Okay. Interesting how all of these things require two people to operate. Well, I honestly thought we were gonna reach the castle today, but turns out we have a lot of other things to do. Where is that husk? Over here. Okay. I wasn't seeing it because this guy was in the way.
I know it's grim, but it needs doing.
Okay. Anything else of interest over here? There's a container, but I'm not, in the bunch of ether channels, but again, not really looking to get into those too hard. Any points of interest here? That is not walkable.
Now we wait.
Yes, that's how an elevator works. Thank you, Noah, for explaining to us the process of using an elevator. Maybe coming down here was not what I needed to do. There is that shiny thing up there. How do I get up there? Oh, that's just the exit. Points of interest are up there. So now we play everybody's favorite game. How do I get up there? Seems getting up there is gonna involve getting up to there. There's some items underneath here. They're not. out underneath. They're back here. Get back up there. Please remove yourself from my path.
You're in our way.
I'm ready. Let's do it.
You're literally in our way.
I don't fear death, so bring it. Inferno's nicely done. Style and substance. Love it. I see you.
I mean, now you're no longer in our way, but we're engaged in battle, so. I wasn't planning on disengaging just because you're out of our path now. Lesson number two of riding in elevators. I suppose that's survivable.
Everyone.
Sure isn't.
I'm sorry.
That felt like a famous last words after the fact. This is probably not the intended solution. Can you please not get in my way? Holy crap, people. So that is definitely not the way that I meant to go down there. But what is?
Now we wait.
Get up here, but then what? I can't get anywhere good from here.
Huh.
Yeah, I might just have to drop it. I don't like to do, but I don't know how to get a thing. Probably not the best idea to just bash my head against it. Especially considering what time it is. Let's head back to Keves Castle region. Did we get any landmarks here other than Colony 11? No. All right. Hold on.
Is this like a rare thing?
It probably is. This one's a little bit more like lava. Let's actually pay attention to our surroundings this time. Almost four full canisters. Then there's a husk over here.
We can't just leave this be.
Might go just a little bit longer today, considering that everything. The idea of not streaming last week, the stream definitely not going as planned on Tuesday. And then half of this stream going out to the bandit server. Professional.
Well,
Demolition. That was the name of a tag team in the WWF back in like the early 90s.
If only you didn't charge off on your own.
You wish you'd get wrecked.
Can y'all please not? Oh, and it's an elite too. Okay. Why are they all elites? And why are there four enemies? This might actually go very poorly. Neo's down. And just before Tyron goes down, they go ahead and hit him for him. Oh, that smarts. That hurt a lot. Finally get to do this.
Nice. That's how you pull off a win.
How could I?
I'm sorry, everyone.
Did we knock him off
this
the edge?
To the back of the castle.
That's actually kind of lame. We almost had him dead.
We're sliding down.
Yep, we sure are. Why is that on the line?
What kind of place is
that? Hovering Reef 7.
Nice landing.
Well, we've been found.
Double demon thing.
Right. We should move right away.
Well, he got the blood pumping at least.
Blug.
Well, visitors.
Oh, hi. Another one friggin' underground.
Strike!
I really would like to actually like get close to the castle. And then in history.
Right, Tile? What's your footing, guys?
I think we can get the shiny thing. Hopefully without bothering that big sky manta ray. Let's get this odd square shard and go. Here, if there's anything
the night is still young.
Of interest, might be over there, but lands, please.
Time to take the fast way. That's interesting. When the auto target picked one of the Ignas in that party, it pointed out that the rest of them were all attached. So basically, if you aggro one of them, you aggro all of them. What can I say? I have a great need for exploration. And I was the MVP. You're all
big. Orders is let's just. Okay, I guess we're fighting them. Someone just acquired a class. Dragon gas sounds very unpleasant. Get this minstrel, it's probably a healer. It's also not elite. Mine is almost down, but Ashera is good to go. And there goes one is back up now. It really sounds like someone's trying to cast Demon Fang. Gosh, a Demon Slayer, but it really sounds like Demon Fang. Oh, can you please not? Alright, we got the elite. Now we have to deal with this additional mosquito. And then an additional mosquito. Oh, full party of elites. Guarding a container. There's also a husk here that's guarded by no one.
I guess this is fate too,
just this one? The answer, of course, is no. Okay, let's make sure we're off. Focus target. Just as they were about to interlink. This is very close quarters, I don't like it. Neo's down, Tyon is at least up. And we've got one of this party down there. Pretty much just gonna blitz this. Because I mean, after all, this is still a party of elites. Not uniques, not bosses. also single-handedly. This is just embarrassing at this point. Yeah, this one I don't even have to try. This literally gave me 109 points. I got hit from the side because I should hopefully hit both of them. This is an annoyingly long battle, and I kind of wish there was a combat timer for things that weren't units. Art mastered.
Cool. I put my head down and pulled us through. I hope we can make use of this.
I hope this isn't complete garbage. That's enough on coins. Alright, let's see if we can get out of here without too much incident. I do not care about these skeeters. I'll just get past all of these guys and across to the next place.
Time to take the fast way!
This is a place called Hovering Ruby 5. There are also some husks here. Yeah, I'll worry about them later. Yep, and the plan is just keep moving. They did. Oh, geez.
Here,
Alright, I guess we're fighting. Try to stay with the party so I can get some heals, hopefully. I don't like how you can't target heals in this game. Oh, come on. Not interested. Thankfully, it seems that enemies will disengage if I start climbing something. They might have had some issues where players would like start climbing something and then they would get sniped by some random enemy and drop off and die. Still on us? Okay, I better actually engage before I... yeah. Because if I engage, then someone can get me out of it. Time to bring out the big guns isn't when the enemy is almost dead. It's when they are kicking our ass.
I think you operate it like so. And then here.
Where does that go?
We're sliding down.
And then all of a sudden we get hit by lightning and just fall off. So why did we come here?
Well, hey, look at that.
Guys, get ready to fight.
So is this just the way back? Well, this was, wasn't it? Just an alternate way back. Now we gotta go. Oh boy.
We're sliding down. Something's surviving
here. Yeah, I'm as surprised as you are. I don't know how a heart peach can survive on a tightrope, but here we are. Yeah, I guess in hindsight here, I could have used the area map to see that that particular wire I just deployed just goes back.
Watch your footing, guys.
Plan is attached to this and they disengage. At least the Moramoras are gone. Not that one, I guess.
Huh? Wait for a moment. Is that... Using that device should allow us to proceed.
You don't say.
Time to take the
I would
bus,
never have guessed that, Tyron. Thank you. Oh, I don't like that, that lightning striking so close to us. See if I can just ignore this unique. We'll come back for it someday. Maybe. Possibly. I'm just making sure that using this wire isn't going to take us directly into an event, because I do want to keep that event for next time. There is a camp here. I'm gonna guess that's where our next event happens. And at this point, I am half an hour over time.
It's good to keep a record.
It's probably best to just keep a record. And we'll see what that event is about next time. So that's going to do it for today's stream. If anyone's out there, thank you for watching. I apologize about the stream technically starting 2 hours into the actual event. That's entirely on me. That's 99% on me. That it should have told me that I was broadcasting to the bandwidth test server, but it didn't do that, so I didn't realize. There are several other hints that could have clued me into the fact that I wasn't streaming to, broadcast. Anyway, what's done is done. The VOD for the part that didn't get broadcast will end up on the YouTube VOD repo, which you can get the link for that in the about box for this channel. There we go. So the next scheduled stream is going to be tomorrow at 8 p.m. or later Atlantic Daylight Time. It is the Sunday Super Shuffle. I'm going to do some Archipelago shenanigans, and if everything goes well, I might actually do a test run for bumper stickers. Yes, that's it. Next stream after that is going to be on Tuesday at 9 p.m. Atlantic Daylight Time. It is the regular long run stream. We're going to play some more Paper Mario The Thousand Year Door and actually get into Chapter 5 like I managed to not do last time because of technical issues that hopefully have been resolved. Let's just say it didn't occur while I was actually recording this time, so that's probably a good thing. Following that is going to be the code creator stream Wednesday at 4 p.m. Programming stuff abounds. There's that. And that takes us around the week, around the wheel, to our next extra long run stream, actually starting at 9 p.m. Atlantic Daylight Time. And this time, we're actually getting into Keves Castle, and there's really not much standing in our way between us and that location, so tune in for that. Anyway, that's gonna do it for today once again. If anyone's out there, thank you for watching. I'm Coolio if you don't know, and I'll see you guys next time.